Very good day to you guys. I hope you're all doing really well this week. I know I'm a little late this week with this TA. I usually do it in the beginning of the week. But nonetheless, guys, let's get straight to the charts and let's take a look and see what's happening. So in my last couple of videos, I had been discussing the potential of us hitting the 9.4 level prior to coming back down. I was, of course, more bearish than I was bullish, based off of TA and nothing else. So for me, we had all these overbought conditions, overbought RSIs, parabolic runs, so on and so forth. And those are all tools that point toward the direction of a pullback in the near future. Now, usually when we hit the overbought region on the weekly, on the RSI, especially on the weekly, there's very likely going to be quite a strong pullback. So that is what I was expecting. But nonetheless, I have mentioned a few times that I'm just a technical analyst and I'm not a future teller, unfortunately. Otherwise, we'd all be sitting on a yacht somewhere in the Mediterranean. Anyway, nonetheless, so let's take a look at the charts and see where we are going. So for me, I mentioned that we were heading towards that 9.495 if we were to break the last all-time high, which at the time was around $8,300. We did. We broke through that. We've opened up a new candle on the green, week after week. And now we are heading toward this 9.495 area. And this zone comes in from the 38.2 Fibonacci zone, which I pulled from the last high to the last low. Our first major resistance area was in the area of around $7,100. We can see we wicked at that part over there. We had broken through that, and now we are heading towards this 38.2, and it's going to happen in increments. The majority of the market is expecting now the price to head that direction. So, that being said, we have to be careful with this thought, because if everyone's expecting it, one thing I've learned is that, the whales somehow come in and just confuse the, confuse the hell out of us by doing the exact opposite. So we just got to be careful in the sense that you want to place your sell orders slightly lower. And as a matter of fact, actually, I wouldn't suggest anyone to even consider selling or have any selling orders or sell orders at this point. Rather run stop losses, okay? And run stop losses based off the last support level. So let's say, for instance, now, okay, we are sitting at $8,700. And the next support level comes in from this line right here, which is roughly $8,300. Okay, so 87 to 83 is $400. That's not a hell of a big drop. But if this level here does not hold, okay, I'm only doing this for the sake of the exercise. So, this may not be the top. So let's just say, for instance, let's pull Fib from the last low. Assuming that this is the top, okay? Assuming that this 9.5 area is the top. Let's put it a little bit higher. No, that's too high. Right there, okay? We can see quite clearly that we've got 23.6 at about $8,000. Okay, so that would be the first support level. So I personally would consider putting a stop loss, slightly below this $8,000 level, because if it does fall back, it's going to come back down to roughly where the 50 MA is, and that's looking at about 5.5 currently on the weekly. It should pull up, but on the weekly it is showing 5.5. More realistically, I would expect a pullback to in and around the $6,400 zone. That's the area that I'm looking at. I hope that makes sense to you. Just make sure that you have your stop losses set at slightly below the last support level. All right. You don't want to sell or have any sell orders, particularly now, because as you can see, TA has been telling us that BTC has been overbought for quite some time, but the thing just carries on running. So, had you sold at this point right here, when we were overbought over here, you would have missed out the run all the way up to this point over here from 7.4 to currently 8.7. So you don't want to have any sell orders, particularly now that the market is shifting. There's a lot of contradictory elements in the market. There's a lot of FOMOing. There's a lot of whale activity. There's a lot of positive news. There's a lot of overbought areas. So there's a lot of conflicting information that's coming into the market. And while we are going into the shift, are we in a bull market yet? or are we going to have a massive pullback and then the real bull market is going to start? So during the shift and during the time that all of this is happening, I mean, a lot of you guys have been holding throughout this entire time. Why sell now? For me, the priority right now is to either preserve what coins you have in your portfolio and or increase the coin quantity with minimal risk. And minimal risk meaning that it doesn't matter, for instance, if the price drops off at the top here at 9.5 and comes back down here to, let's say, this $8,400 level, because if you sell at the top here and come down here, I mean, we're talking $800-$900. That's not a huge difference, okay? So your dollar value of your portfolio may drop, but at least your coin quantity remains the same, okay? And that is the priority, because at the end of the next bull run, you want to have as much coin as possible, all right? So forget about the temporary pullbacks in terms of your dollar value and focus on your BTC value, nothing else, okay? With minimal, absolute minimal risk. Okay, so that being said, on the weekly, we're saying that 9.495 is the target. Let's take a look at the daily and see if we can find any other information off of that. So here we can see that we've been playing in and around, so coming in and out of this overbought region as well on the RSI. We still have this golden cross at play, which is a beautiful, beautiful play. Let's run Fibonacci one more time. I keep pushing the wrong things here. I apologize. So let's go the last high to the last low, see where we're sitting at the moment. Okay, so this is not coincidence, all right? If you look at this level right here, okay, we can see we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 candles trying to break through the zone. You can see that I don't have any resistance lines here because there aren't. There is no candle formation. This is 100% Fibonacci, okay? This is where the concept of 161.8 push and pull, with all mathematical background of Fibonacci comes in. So it's no coincidence that we are sitting at exactly 127.2, but the target is roughly this area up here, and then 161 sits in at about $9,200, which is slightly below my resistance at about 9.3. So we're looking between 9.2 and 9.5. If you want to play it conservatively and you do still want to sell, which I don't really suggest that you do, I would rather run stop losses. But that being said, if you do want to sell, between 9.2 and 9.5 is the area. Okay, I hope that makes sense to you. Lastly, let's take a look at the 4-hour as well, see if there are any formations on this. Okay, so we've got the support of the 50 MA that's coming in line with the next support area of roughly $8,300. So if you want to trade, you know, intraday on this 4-hour chart, I would set stop loss slightly below over here at about $8,000 with a buyback at the next support, which comes in at about $6,900 and then around $6,400 as well. All right, let's take a quick look at XRP as well. Okay. I know I don't usually do this, but let's take a quick look. Start off with the weekly. All right. So I had sent out a message a couple of days ago letting you guys know that XRP was about to break out based off of this information right here. I'd been eyeing this for quite some time. I saw the divergence coming in, and I saw that the 50 MA was about to cross this. And if you look very carefully, okay, where is it? On the daily. So let's pull this back a little bit. We've got what's called quite a big cup, but nonetheless a cup and handle formation. And here's the cup, more like a soup bowl, but nonetheless it is a cup. I'm not going to argue with the guys who came up with the name, but there it is over there. And on completion of this cup with handle, we have a breakout at this point over here with the golden cross that comes in the same place, will take us straight to the next area, which is roughly 58 cents. In the region of, okay, so that's your target for XRP. Let's take a look at the 4-hour as well. We keep bouncing off this 50 MA. It's looking good. We are reaching the last all-time high, which is in the region of about 46-47 cents. We are playing in and out of this overbought region on this RSI as well. But you know, if we looked at this daily, we still haven't even come into the overbought region. And if we looked at the weekly, in comparison to BTC, we still have quite a way to go to get into the overbought area on this XRP chart. So, you know, for me, let's just draw this line at the top here. So our next resistance comes in. So we have this one here roughly, which is probably going to play a significant role. And then we've got one slightly higher, which comes in right there. Okay, that comes in from this area over here. So based off the cup and handle on the daily, all right, that I had drawn out for you guys, your target is in the area of 58 cents. Now, if we pull Fibonacci from this last high to the last low, we've got, let's just have a look-see. We've got the 61.8, which plays a very similar area in terms of that 60 cent, 58, 60 cent area. But if we ran Fibonacci from the last high to the last low, let's take a look there and see what Fib tells us. 1 second. Okay, so Fib is telling us we've got the 23.6, which is roughly 55 cents. So we have the 61.8 that's telling us 60, that's telling us 60 cents. We've got the 23.6 that's telling us 55 cents. And then, of course, we have to use Fibonacci with our resistance areas. And that being said, that comes in at about 58 cents. We can see there is a slight support, a resistance in this area here. Let me just make this a bit bigger. And we can delete this. So we've got a slight support or resistance area right here as well. So that could, so that can be considered a resistance as well. But the strongest resistance comes in slightly higher, which is in this area right here. Okay. So these are the resistance areas. We may target this 55 cent and maybe even see a pullback from that point. So just be careful of that. So in a nutshell, based off Fibonacci and the resistance zones, I'm looking for a breakout towards 55 to about 58 cents with a little bit of resistance at about 50 cents as well. And that is it for XRP. Guys, if you need any TA on your personal portfolios, do let me know. You know, just this last weekend, most of my clients that are on the Pocket Consultant package definitely benefited from this XRP move along with BTC's move to the upside, despite my bearish mindset of my last video. As you all know, I only do one or two videos a week, but of course my clients will get priority in terms of buy and sell targets. So if you want that benefit, please reach out to me and I will certainly get back to you. Guys, wishing you a fantastic week ahead, and I will get back to you again next week with an update. Cheers for now.